The winter weather emergency in Texas and much of the South is getting worse, with millions facing yet another night in the dark with no heat and no clean water. This relentless winter blast is blamed for at least 24 deaths this week. One-third of Americans are in the path of a second winter storm, with the snow and ice headed to the East Coast. Families in Houston and all over Texas are doing anything to stay warm, sometimes making deadly choices. 911 calls are up throughout Texas. Hospitals have treated hundreds for exposure to the cold and for carbon monoxide poisoning as Texans fire up generators and stay in their cars to keep warm. Frustration is boiling over as utilities scramble to try to restore power. As officials point fingers, one thing is clear. Texas did not weatherproof many of its power-generating facilities or pipelines, despite being hit by a similar freeze about a decade ago. More than 2.5 million are in the dark with no heat for a third day. Frozen pipes are bursting, flooding homes and businesses. One Dallas apartment building had icicles inside. So many pipes have now burst. Texas's governor is asking for help from out-of-state plumbers as many counties warn their water could be contaminated and needs to be boiled. Stephen and Laura Dandridge told CBS News that they would have never expected these conditions in the Lone Star State. They have been living in the dark and cold for most of the past 3 days with their one-year-old son Bobby. A boil water order has been issued for all of Houston and dozens of cities. However, in hard-hit areas, there is no water to boil because the taps are dry. Almost half of the state's 254 counties are experiencing water woes. Harris County Judge Lena Hidalgo compared it to Hurricane Harvey in 2017. This is very different from Harvey, but the scope of the impact is absolutely equivalent, and it's something that is impacting not just the millions of people here in Harris County, but all throughout Texas, Hidalgo said.